Paul here from LetsRun.com. Question for Conceslus. I'm wondering, can you explain your celebration after crossing the finish line? What inspired it?
Good evening, team medalist. First of all, I want to congratulate Al Bogali and Karame. I think about the competition today, it was really difficult. It was a hard competition. I knew it before. And then in the last, I can talk about the last lap. My plans was to be, when it comes to the last lap, I know I was going to kick. But actually, in the last 200 meters, I was with Al Bogali. I knew it. We only going to cook the last 100 meters with Al Bogali. And then at certain of the boy, I behind another guy who was like, ha. He was really passing in a high speed, that was a Karame. And then I changed my plans very fast, like it's not Al Bogali anymore. So I focused with Karame. And then actually I planned like to jump the last barrier with Karame. But actually I was about to make some mistakes because he was a couple of meters. He jumped before me. But actually, I strong mine, which made me to kick so hard. And then in my mentality, there was two things in my mind. Like I didn't want to be called like for world champion. I didn't want to lose this event because I wanted actually to save this event, because we always say this event is a Kenyan event. So actually, those two things made me to kick. But it was a tie. I didn't win I knew it. I was the winner. So after we tied, I was praying let be the first name to be consensus. And actually, I wait. I just pray, and then I just look at the screen, and I found it was consensus. It was my name. And actually, that made me happy, and I was impressed by that. Yeah, you know about my celebration. You know, I always say this, in the celebration, I was telling the people, you have seen, I'm still there. After my injuries, people were thinking actually I'm not going to make it when it comes to World Cup. That's why I was telling the bodies, and I was telling the people in the world, you see, I'm still there. And actually, I was there to save the event. I was there to save my title.
Question to the gentleman here on the first row, and then it will be you.
This is an example from the sport. My question is for the nature. How does it feel losing the World Championship medal for just one microsecond?
Yeah, let me check the year again. Let me check. በአንድ ማይክሮ ሰከንድ ቀድመ ከፍተኛ በመሆነ ምንድን የተሰማ ስሜት?
As you saw, the weather was good, and this race was good for me. And I thought that I stood first, but unfortunately, with that 1 microsecond, I lost the gold.
The gentleman there in the front row.
Question to Conceslus. He spoke about the injury you had this summer. When did you start running normally again, and how slow was your fitness in coming back?
According to my injury, I injured it after I came back from work contact, that was in April, about somewhere every week, and I took 2.5 months without training. But actually, in that 2 months, I stayed 1 month without doing anything. And then in the other month, I decided to build I'll probably wake up like to do some exercise. That would impress many people were thinking like what is this? So I made that pool, I was really running that pool. It was like 5 meters and 4 meters. So that helped me a lot. And then after I started started somewhere in the mid-June. Yeah, I'm not thinking it was amazing. But actually according to my coach plans, I didn't plan like I was going to return back before the last 2 times. But actually I asked him then before trainings in Paris, and actually I went there, but according to his plans, he knew that I was not going to make there, but actually I had that courage like my coach in the court ride. And then they let me, you know, like for me, wanting to go try to get with these guys, to see where I am, and then go back for training, my aim, it was indeed what I was doing. Then I went for the last time of week, it was in process, I think well, the way people were thinking. But actually, I knew it. Of course, I was working on the long runs, my day at that time. After I returned back from the last time of week, I went only for speed. And that's what impressed me today. And actually, you know, after running my semifinals, I knew it was in good shape. And Paul wrote a message to me like, you see, he knew it was in good shape, but he told me he was going to win it. And I had mentality too, I told him, yeah, you are right, I'm in good shape at the right time. He came at the right time, and I'm going to do it when it comes to the final. And I'm happy I did.
For Lamecha, why do you think Ethiopia has now gotten so good in the steeplechase, where before it was mostly Kenya at the front? Why do you think Ethiopia now is doing so well at the steeplechase this year?
I think we did best, especially in our field, 3,000 meter steeplechase. So that's why I stood second and received the silver medal.
Any other questions? Gentlemen here in the third row.
A question for Sylvia Bakari. Sylvia, يعني كنت من المرشحين لفوز بالميدالية يعني هذه الانطلاقة اللي كانت قبل الدورة الأخيرة هي اللي خلت أنك تضيع الميدالية الذهبية واللقب العالمي خاصة أنك كان عندك ميدالية فضية في البطولة السابقة.
بالنسبة لي أنا فرحان بالشتوية ديالي بالميدالية الفرنسية كنت كنطمح أنني نفوز بالميدالية الذهبية نظرا لصعوبات السباق كان سباق قوي جدا سباق سريع اللي صراحة حتى واحد ممكن يتوقع ان السباق غادي يكون سريع كلكم كيتهضر ان السباق يكون تكتيكي ولكن قبل الفوتين ملي عكزت كثير وعرفت بلي السباق غيكون سريع كنت كنتهضر ان المدة الأخيرة باش نتعرق في السباق لكن خلتني اللياقة البدنية في آخر 20 متر وماشي مشكل خير فيما اختار والله انا راضي جدا على المركز هذا وراضي على المستوى اللي كنت فيه هذه السنه وبالمناسبه كان العداء خصيصا سكي بورتو والاتلت لميشا بالفوز ديالهم بالذهبيه والميداليه في الكره.
The question was about how satisfied is the Moroccan athlete about this bronze medal, especially that in the previous World Championships he had the silver medal, and the athlete answered that he is satisfied about the what he achieved today because the race was very tough and the competition was very difficult, and he said that he would have liked to have won the gold, or run for the gold, or the silver, and he tried his best. He knew that it would be tactical and fast, and he attacked at a certain time, a few hundred meters before, and he gave everything he had, but the two athletes who won the gold and medal were very competitive, and they finished better than him, and he is satisfied by what he got, and he congratulates the two winners for the gold and silver.
One last question from the gentleman there in the back.
My question goes to Conceslas. You're known to have a great connection with the crowd and fans whenever you run. How important was it for you tonight to have a full house here pushing you?
Yeah, honestly, it was a great crowd. It was great. I was happy when I saw a large crowd from Kenya. I saw the church room was full, and then before we started with, there was a certain groupies that were like hearing and singing about my name, singing about the country. They were saying the victory belongs to Kenya, this game belongs to Kenya. And actually that made me like I'm going to fight again until I win this event. It gave me a lot of morale, and actually I was so happy like having such a crowd. Like, you know, it was almost the taking my attention from the competition. Because when I was here, I was running, I was hearing my name and I was like, what are they talking about me? And then I was saying I was almost like confusing, they were almost confusing me. But when I think about them, when I think the way they think about my name, they made me really, in fact, you know, like I was not like thinking this race was going to be that so fast, like 8-1. Even after crossing the finish line, I think we need to do that in one championship. And then that crowd made me actually fight until the last 2 minutes.